Today the concept is understanding secularism. What is the meaning of secularism? So, in order to understand the actual meaning of secularism, the real scenario what happens in US, for example, if you move to US and you are following either the religion of Hinduism or Islam religion, the Islam known as Muslims. So when you go to search houses, you start to move from one place to another place searching a house, because most of the people in United States of America belong or believe in the religion of Christianity. They are Christian fundamentalists. So they deny giving house to you. They deny to give rent for you. So as the time passes on you, after a certain point of time, you start to feel very bad, because this kind of discrimination should not be in existence. Because your religion should not be a part to determine whether the house should be given to you or not. Some other reason could be acceptable, but not religion. So as the time passes on, you will try to find, you try to get angry on that. Then if you take this issue to the authorities, then if they reply for you saying that this is like this only, you can go back to India, then you still get worst anger situation. Then we come to a conclusion that even the Americans or the other religious people, for example, like in India we have Hindus more, so the same Christians and Muslims also should be meted in the same way how they are treating for us in United States of America. We jump to conclusions very soon basing on our experiences, but actually that is a wrong assumption what we are going. We should not go to such kind of things. The discrimination has to be questioned. Because even in United States of America, the state does not interfere in the religious matters. The religion does not interfere in the state matters. The state here stands for government. So that separation is there. So it is only the people who are acting there. So the actual meaning of secularism is that the religion should not be a part and parcel of your discrimination part. And at the same time, in any part of your life, it should not be influencing us. Religion is something which is personal to you, and it should not be added with any other attributes or the advantages of it. So the actual original sense of secularism is religion is separate, you are separate. When I am speaking to you, I should not have the context of whether you are a Hindu or a Christian or a Muslim. I have to consider you as a human being, and you have to talk to me as a human being. We should share our feelings as a human being, and religion is something which is far off from our discussions. You are free to follow any religion. I am free to follow any religion. I should not be bound or restricted to follow the same religion what you are following, or you should not be bound and restricted to follow anything which I am following. You can follow your religion. I can follow my religion. I have to respect your religious traditions and customs. You have to respect my religion, traditions and customs. So this is called the original sense of secularism. Let us move on to the Indian context. As you all know, in India, 80% of them belong to the religion of Hinduism. And very few people, 1%, the other religious people like Buddhists. We have the various communities representing their religious people. So clearly the statistics reveal for us that 10 to 12% are Christians, 8% are Muslims. This means that 80% of the Hindus are in majority, which can clearly state that the decision of the majority should prevail over the minority. This is a democratic principle what is ensured for us. But in actual terms, when it comes to religion, any majority religion should not curb the freedom of the minority religion. Democracy clearly guarantees that each and every individual, each and every person is free to follow his own religion. There is no restriction on any individual to follow this religion or that religion. That is the reason why even in the United States of America, they clearly brought the demarcation very clear that state versus religion. State should not interfere in the religious matters. At the same time, state should not come into the religious matter. Religious should not dominate the state affairs. State should not interfere in the religious matters. It means that religion is something which is separate. Government is something which is separate. This separation of powers has brought from the US. India also has this kind of separation of powers, but not in regarding to religion and government, but government clearly states that any religion cannot be an official religion for us. India has picked up to be a secular country because India has an experiences of the communal riots which happened when India got partitioned. When India got partitioned, India has saw the bitterness of that. What is the actual problem of that? So India and Pakistan were separated only and only on the basis of religion. So Hindus troubling the Muslims, Muslims troubling the Hindus in the extreme border regions, and most of the Hindus lost their properties in Pakistan because they have to get migrated from there. Most of the Muslims in India lost their properties because they have to get migrated to Pakistan. These kind of incidents made very clear for the constitutional framers in India that they should not stick up to any particular religion. In the same way, the United States also stands on the principle of secularism lines, but it has some different setup, but it also respects the other religions equally with their religion. They divide the religion and state separately and consider both of them as equal representatives of each other and never interfere in one another matters. US has passed certain laws clearly stating that none of the religion can be declared as an official religion, especially even though 90% of the US people belong to believe in the Christianity, but they never stick on to declare Christianity as a basic stand or national religion. And they also claimed in the law that this should not be done in future also. India, in this regard, India clearly states that India is a secular state in the preamble itself and never gives any importance to any religion. Now, in order to understand this very clearly, in an example, we have seen the people are denied houses in US, those are non-Christians. In the same way, in India also we have various incidences which prove that there is religious discrimination to certain extent at various places. For example, recently an incident happened. The Hindu Shiv Sena member of parliament forces the Muslim who is doing fasting because of this roza effect of this 40-day session of Ramzan. So they are doing fasting from morning till evening and then they break their fast. This man forced him to take some of the supplements during the fasting time. It created and hit the parliament benches very strongly and objecting the religious secularistic attitude where this was crossed to certain limit. Yes, here and there are some instances where which are affecting the basic secularistic attitude of the people. We can have a memory of Gujarat riots which happened in 2002 where the Muslims were hit badly. Most of the Muslims were cut short, their heads were cut. It's like brutal thing which happened in the history of Gujarat. So there is a domination of Hindus over the Muslims. Recently in Uttar Pradesh, Muzaffar Jung region, where Muslims and Hindus clashes were again reborn. These kind of instances are appearing here and there, but constitutionally India never supports or sticks on to any particular religion. It clearly states, and India never stands, especially Indian government never stands in support of one religion or criticizing the other religion. India stands neutral and tries to stop if any kind of allegations which are made against the government or against any individual who tries to break the secularistic setup of the Indian setup.